Saroj Kaushik is professor in Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi since 2002. She obtained her PhD degree in Computer Science from IIT Delhi in 1980 and joined as faculty in the same year. She has about 36 years of teaching and research experience in IIT Delhi. Her interests are in the fields of artificial intelligence, including natural language processing, agents, genetic algorithms, knowledge representation. Recently, she is working in location-based services and social networks analysis. She has successfully supervised many PhD students and currently is supervising a few more PhD students. She has collaborated on 7 research projects and completed 1 consultancy project. She published 2 books, one on logic and prolog programming and other on artificial intelligence. She has more than 85 refereed papers in journal and international conferences. She has guided about 100 theses at MTech and BTech level. She has been examiner for many theses at PhD and MS level. She is on the board of studies of various universities and institutions and was Senate member of NIT Hamirpur. She is a member of faculty selection committees of various universities and institutes. She was invited by MUM University, Fairfield, Iowa State, USA as a visiting professor for teaching artificial intelligence course and guiding the master's students for their project in 2008-2004. She has visited a number of universities abroad and has presented many research papers in good international conferences held in US, Canada, Europe, Australia, Algeria, Malaysia, Japan, Singapore, and China. She had won Best Paper Awards at IEEE, ICMWI 2010 at Algiers, Algeria, ICWCA 2012 at Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, ICCSA 2015, Banff, Canada. She held various administrative posts, such as Head of Computer Science and Engineering, Associate Dean for Student Welfare, Head of Counseling Cell, President of BSW, House Master and Warden of Girls Hostel, etc. She is very active in institutional activities. She is fellow member of Institute of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineers and a life member of Computer Society of India. A true academician, a thorough researcher, and an able administrator. I extend a very warm welcome to Dr. Saroj Kaushik, a personality par excellence in her field. May I now request Dr. Prerna Mahajan, HOD IT, to give ma'am a floral welcome.
Thank for such an elaborate introduction of mine, and let me confess, I'm really, really privileged to be on your campus, and first time I've come here, and it's very really environment is looking very good, and I met Professor Sharma, so I'm finding it like he's taking so much of interest in the institution, and that shows that yes, the institution can go very high. Basically, my talk is not very technical, but maybe I'll introduce with the area of AI. Most of you might have maybe read or heard also, but I'll try to relate this with human intelligence. Okay, so maybe I'll go here away little bit differently also, so please bear with me. So artificial intelligence basically means what? We are trying to simulate or try to inculcate the intelligence part using computers artificially.
More than that,
so I'll have these kind of contents which I'll be going through. Artificial intelligence, what are the characteristics of such programs, categories of such systems, how to prove that this system is artificial intelligent. So there is a Turing test, foundation of AI. So these are various categories under which I'll be talking. Now, before going to any formal slide, I just want to start with, when we are saying that artificial intelligence is an area, but are we sure enough what is intelligence? What is real intelligence? We'll come to artificial a little later, but we should understand what is intelligence as such. So intelligence, generally, how we perceive about intelligence in humans. I'll try to relate the human system with the computer, okay? So what is the actual intelligence? How we perceive about that this is the intelligence? What are the characteristics of those intelligence? Generally, we say the person is intelligent if the person has the ability to understand, maybe act smartly, and also maybe learn and solve the problem intelligently. Those are the vague definitions of real intelligence. So first we have to be sure about what are the real intelligence properties, and then only we'll come to how we can make the systems to be intelligence artificially. So artificial intelligence, quick answer from academia. These are few definitions given in the book. Modeling human cognition or mental faculty using computers. Study of making computers do things which at the moment people are better. Now we have seen that computers are really doing wonders. The people cannot do the things which computers are doing. But there are some areas, gray areas, where the humans are more intelligent than the computers. For example, a child of maybe 3-4 months, the kind of intelligence that child possesses, capturing that into computer sometimes is difficult. Okay, so now the whole effort of AI is to make computers do things at which right now people are better, and making computers do things which require then of course intelligence. More formal definition, basically we can say is like this. AI is a branch of computer science which is concerned with the study and creation of computer systems that exhibit some form of intelligence, and those characteristics, or maybe those characteristics which we associate with intelligence in human behavior. AI is a broad field consisting of things like machine vision, expert systems, and creation of machines that can think. Okay? In order to classify machines as thinking, it is necessary to define intelligence. So now I'll come to formal definition of intelligence. So the formal definition could be something like this. Intelligence is a property of mind, okay, that encompasses many related mental abilities such as reasoning, planning, solving problems, thinking abstractly, comprehending ideas, and learning like this. So now let's take the human system. Are we knowing that how human system works? What happens? Everyone knows that we think, we do some actions, we speak, all these are the actions we are doing. Thinking part, how it is done? What happens? What is the cycle inside? generally, sometimes we are not even able to differentiate whether thought has come first or the feeling has come first. But the general, there are three faculties of the energy which is flowing in the human body. Three faculties basically, one is the mind, where the thinking happens. Thoughts are coming and going. Another is intellect, which basically gives you judgment on the thought which has come in the mind. And third is, when the action is performed, then after each performance of the action, it leaves a mark in our storage, which is invisible definitely. And this, when repeated actions are done, the same actions, that basically mark gets darkened and darkened, and that becomes your habit. So this is the cycle. First thought will come, then intellect will get that thought, and then action will happen. And once action has happened, the recording is done in some subtle level which we are not able to see. Just like in computers, what happens? We have a hardware and software. Software, how the things are stored, we are not able to see. But hardware components, we can see. Same thing is happening here. We have the body, this is my hardware component, and then we have something inside flowing. Everyone agrees with this? Some energy is flowing inside, you call anything, but some energy is flowing through which we can just work using this body. Now this energy is when thinking, it becomes mind, when giving judgment, it becomes intellect, and when actions are done, the storage is done, and this is called sanskar or sanchit storage. Now what is happening in this entire cycle? How these habits are created? And now it's a self-learning system. Now if you have to build a system in computer, we should be understanding how the cognition works. So what is happening? For example, child from the childhood, I mean, whatever he knows, he could express. Later on, maybe even in school, he wants to start something like drinking or smoking.